Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the complete explanation for ACID properties in database management system as well as serializability. Okay, first let's discuss about ACID properties. Let's begin our video now. ACID properties, in ACID properties, A stands for atomicity, C stands for consistency, I stands for isolation, and D stands for durability. Okay, so now let's see the individual explanation for atomicity, consistency, isolation, as well as durability. Okay, so why are we, first let's see why are we using ACID properties. Okay, why are we using ACID properties is in order to improve the performance of the transaction and in order to make the transaction complete successfully without any errors. Okay, so first let's see what is atomicity. Coming to atomicity, when we want to run a transaction, when there is a transaction executing, the transaction should either complete fully, like completed successfully, or it should fail completely. I'll explain you what does this mean. Atomicity means the transaction, when we run a transaction or when there is a transaction, it should either complete successfully or it should fail completely. Okay, it should not be like half successful transaction and half failure transaction. It should not be like that. Means, for example, I want to, like for example, 50,000 rupees are credited to my account. For example, 50,000 rupees are credited to my account. Okay, so this is one transaction. Okay, so coming to this particular transaction, 50,000 should successfully credit to my account or it should not at all credited. Okay, it should either credit successfully or it should fail completely. Not like, for example, person A, person B, okay? A is sending 20K rupees to B, okay? A is sending 20K to B, okay? So, this is one transaction. It should be like money sent to B successfully from A. This is one transaction, which is successful transaction. Another possibility is failure transaction. Money not sent, 20K not sent, so it is a failed transaction. It should, any transaction should be either successful or failure. It should not be like one of the other possibilities that money is cut from this account, 20K is deducted from A's account, but it is not credited to B's account. It should not be like that. It should successfully go from A to B, or it should not go, it should not deduct from A and not credit to B. It should not be like it didn't go to B's account, but it the amount didn't go to B's account, but amount got cut into A's account. No, this should not be the possibility and this should not be the case. Okay, so every transaction must have atomicity. Okay, so second in ACID property, second one is consistency. Consistency means each and every transaction should be consistent. Consistent means it should be up to date. It should be the correct information. Okay, it should not be fictitious information. Okay, so coming to next, isolation. Isolation is nothing but, for example, there are two people, A, B. A is performing one transaction, at the same time B is also performing some other transaction. Okay, see, I'm explaining you isolation. There are two people, there are two persons, A, B. A is at the same time, A and B are doing two different transactions. Okay, because of this transaction, this B's transaction should not be affected. Okay, both the transactions are individual and independent transaction. Okay, this should run separately as well as this should run separately. This is called isolation. One transaction should not affect the another transaction. Last but not least, durability. After this, let's see what is serialization. Okay, serialization is also one of the most important concept in DBMS. Now let's see what is the durability. For example, let's take 1 week as consideration. Okay, in 1 week there are some 20,000, for example, there are some 20,000 transactions took place within 1 week. Okay, 1 week means 7 days, right? In 7 days, 20,000 transactions took place, and on the 8th day, means after 1 week, next day, the system got crashed. But still, the system, like the database, should be able to recover the transactions. It should still have the 20,000 transaction in saved mode. Okay, though the system got crashed, it cannot just clear all the transactions. Though the system is crashed, still the system or the database should be able to recover store the 20K transactions which took place the day before the system crash. Okay, so this is also important. Okay, the database should always be in a position to store the transactions, store the value data, though the system gets crashed or though the system has some other issue, still all the transactions should be saved. Okay, should be in the saved mode. So these are the four asset properties which are very important. Now let's see what is serialization. Okay, now let's see what is serialization. Coming to serializability, let's take some transaction or action. Okay, let us denote action as capital A. Okay, so every transaction will have several actions. For example, amount debited is an action, amount credited is an action, all those such things are actions. Okay, so A is, we are denoting action as A. Okay, so with every action we can do two things. We can write the action, we can read the action. Okay, read the action means we cannot manipulate this action. Okay, it is just like read only. Write the action means you can write on the action, you can rewrite the action. Okay, so write action means W of A, read action means R of A. This is one important concept. Now coming to serializability, serializability means, for example, let it be like there are two different transactions. Okay, A is a transaction, B is a transaction. A is doing some few actions or transactions, B is also doing some transactions. First A should, because A is first, right? So A should execute all the transactions first, and then B should execute all its transactions first. It means the transactions should happen in the serial order. Okay, first A's transactions should run successfully and then B's transactions should run successfully. Means transactions happening in a serial order, it is known as serialization or serializability. Okay, serializability. This is also one of the most important concept. Okay, so that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also don't forget to hit the bell icon for more such wonderful video notifications. Please like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching and all the very best for your exam.